This is from Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. And Imam Muttafaq Alayh, and Imam Bukhari has quoted this hadith 5 times in his Sahih Bukhari. And same way, 5 times or more times, Imam Muslim has quoted in Sahih Muslim, Muttafaq Alayh hadith. And the narrator is Anas ibn Malik Ansari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And the words of hadith are, Inna Aba Bakrin kana yusalli lahum fi waja'in nabiyyi alladhi tuwaffiya fihi hatta iza kana yawmul isnain wuhum sufufun fi salat. فَكَاشَفَ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم سِتْرَ الْحُجْرَةِ يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْنَا وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ وَكَانَّ وَجْهَهُ وَرَقَةُ مَصْحَفٍ ثُمَّ تَبَسَّمَ يَدْهَكُ فَهَمَمْنَا أَنْ نَفْتَتِنَا مِنَ الْفَرْحِ بِرُؤْيَةِ النَّبِيِّ صلى الله عليه وسلم فَنَاكَسَ أَبُو بَكْرٍ عَلَى عَقِبَيْهِ لِيَصِلَ الصَّفَّ وَظَنَّ أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ صلى الله عليه وسلم خَارِجٌ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَأَشَارَ إِلَيْنَ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم أَنْ أَتِمُّ صَلَاتَكُمْ وَأَرْخَ الصِّتْرِ. This is Muttafaq Alayh Hadith. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, Malik, Anas ibn Malik reports that he was used to lead the companions in the ritual prayers during the departing ailment of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the, his last 3 days. He was leading the prayer. And Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in his last ailment on his bed. Meanwhile, Holy Prophet ﷺ felt better. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was leading the prayer, and the companions was aligned in rows, and they were in their prayer. They were hum sufufun fis salat. Wama qala hum sufufun lis salat. Bal qala hum sufufun fis salat. They were in prayer. They were praying. They were not stating the rows for prayer. No, fis salat means they were already in their prayer. These are the words of hadith. Please keep in your mind the text of hadith. Hum sufufun fis salat. They were in state of prayer. It was Monday, and they were offering the ritual prayer. When beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised the curtain of his door, raised the curtain of his sacred chamber, and he was standing there and blessed us with this compassionate gaze, which we were missing so restlessly and waiting for so impatiently. For the last 3 days, they couldn't see Holy Prophet's face. They were restless. They were waiting for that gaze. For that gaze. All of a sudden, Holy Prophet raised the curtain of his chamber, holy chamber. And companions say, Kanna vajau varakata musafin summa tabassama wa yadhagu fahamamna an naftatina min salati biruyatin nabi. So companions were standing in their rows like this. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq was leading the prayer. And you know, just if you imagine, Holy Prophet's chamber, his house was on the extreme left of the companions, Riyadul Jannah. The Jali Mubarak is on extreme left. And they were standing like this. Just now you tell me, if the people are praying towards facing Kaaba, do they see right or left, or just they concentrate on their place of their prostration, sajdaga? They always concentrate on their place of prostration, on the sajda place. And were Sahaba accustomed to see right and left during their prayer? No, nobody is accustomed. You can't do. When they were just concentrating on their prostration place during the prayer, Holy Prophet was standing extreme left, raising the curtain of his chamber, of holy chamber. How Sahaba were able to see his smiling face? This is hadith. Muttafaq alayh hadith. How, Anas ibn Malik says, how were Sahaba able to see his smiling face and glittering face? An illuminating face. How could they see his face? Because they were standing like this, facing towards the prostration place. He was standing in his door. He did not come out of his chamber. On door raising the... How could they see his face? And how they say, we saw him, he was smiling. And his face looked as if the Quran was open in front of them. And his face was so illuminating. How could they see? How were they could see this compassionate gaze? How was this possible? It is absolutely not possible unless somebody praying turns his face towards left. When they heard raising of the curtain, they heard this noise, they knew Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa or the Azwaj, the wife, holy wives, cannot raise the curtain. You understand? They knew Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa cannot raise the curtain. And she cannot come on the door to stand to see us. If the curtain is raised and somebody has appeared on the door, it means this is just Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When they knew that Holy Prophet is standing on the door, they forget the direction of Kaaba. And all of these companions turned their faces towards the face of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Now Kaaba was on this side and face of Holy Prophet, Kaaba of Kaaba, was on that side. On this side was the Qibla. And on extreme left was the Qiblatul Qibla. They turned their faces towards Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the words are, فَهَمَمْنَا أَن نَفْتَتِنَا مِنَ الْفَرْحِ بِرُؤْيَةِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And when we glanced, we had nearly ended our prayer. And we had decided to end our prayer, to break our prayer, just to see the beautiful face of Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is the companions are saying. We intended to break the prayer, to end our prayer, to see Holy Prophet's face, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this was the position of the companions. But what happened to the Imam? We had nearly ended our prayer due to the extreme joy of having blissful and heartening glimpse and beholding of the pleased and gleaming holy countenance of our beloved Prophet. Now what happened to Imam Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu? He initiated, he thought as if Holy Prophet has come out from his holy chamber. He is joining us in prayer. So he initiated to drag himself on his soles to join the row behind the leader. He left the musalla, the prayer, the place of Imam, and he dragged himself behind to the first row, and he left the place for Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You see, this is the prayer. The companions, just to see, have a beautiful view of the face of Holy Prophet, they have turned their faces towards left. Imam has left his musalla place to join the first row, thinking as if Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has himself come out. When Holy Prophet saw whole of this scene, but our beloved Prophet gave us the gesture and he said, Atimmu salatakum, just complete your prayers. Arkhas sitr, and he pulled down the curtain and went back. And he never said, repeat the prayers. Because the Imam has left his place, he is joining the first row. The all Sahaba, they have turned their face, they are busy in watching my face. So now what is left in prayer? So he would have said, Salat dubara namaz ko phir se padho toot gayi. Chunke tumhare chehre Kaabe se hat gaye. Imam ne musalla chhod diya. Rukh badal gaye. If you while praying turn your face toward right or left, your prayer is broken. But Holy Prophet did not say, repeat your prayers. He said, Atimmu salatakum, just complete your prayers. You are still in prayer. You are still in prayer in spite of the fact that Imam has left his place and you have turned towards left. You have changed your direction of faces, but still you are dealing with Prophet Muhammad, the messenger. It is known to be dealing with Almighty Allah. It is known to be dealing with Almighty Allah. As you did your bay'ah on the hands of Holy Prophet, bay'atul ridwan, and Allah declared, Inna allazeena yubayi'unaka innama yubayi'un Allah. You are doing your bay'ah on the hands of Holy Prophet. This is not bay'ah on his hand, this is bay'ah on Allah's hand. In the same way, in spite of the fact, if you turn your face for anybody else, your prayer would be broken. But now you have turned your face towards the face of Muhammad, peace be upon him. And his face is much better than the face of Kaaba. His face is higher than Kaaba. Still you are dealing with Almighty Allah's remembrance, because Allah has made his remembrance his own remembrance, and he has joined both remembrances together.